The president of the National Unity Platform has expressed disappointment over the police blockade that barred him from meeting his supporters in Isingiro district. Speaking to journalists at Rad Hotel this morning, Kyagulanyi said security forces have consistently blocked him from meeting his supporters during his mobilization tours.
We continue to condemn the discriminative behavior of police, blocking us from the venues that other people are having functions in, and also trying to intimidate the radio stations not hosting us.
Kyagulanyi stated that the tours have opened his eyes to the condition that people are living in. Kyagulanyi also spoke tough against acts of corruption, saying nobody should be spared, regardless of their party. NUP Secretary General David Louis Rubongoya gave an account of what transpired during their nationwide mobilization campaign.
The people who are in the thing, as they call it, are just a small group of people who are connected to the power center. But majority of the people of Western Uganda, just like all other regions in this country, are suffering.
The court has deferred the ruling of bail application by the former Rubaga Division Deputy Resident City Commissioner Herbert Anderson Burora. Burora appeared before Justice Sanula Nambozo, who was sitting in for Chief Magistrate Ronald Kaizi, who is reportedly away for an official management training. Prosecution led by Joan Keko and Richard Bidivumbuka informed the court that they had prepared a response to the bail application put in by the defense bench. However, they asked for adjournment till 25th July, since the presiding judge, Ronald Kaizi, is away.
Your Worship, we were ready with our reply, but for the absence of the trial magistrate, she can adjourn.
The defense lawyer, led by Philip Munabi, did not object to the prayer. However, they asked for a nearby date other than 25th of July.
Seek that states agrees to that date of Monday, 22nd.
And Monday, have a matter of Uganda versus Katumba and others before Justice Alice Komoha at the ICT. This is one of the arguments we raised last week in defense of the. I wish they had listened to us.
In her judgment, Justice Sanula Nambozo ruled that the next court hearing shall be on 25th July next week. Burora is battling charges of hate speech and spreading malicious information. The prosecution alleges that between March and June 2024 in the areas of Kampala district or thereabout, while using a computer via his ex handle, Anderson Burora shared malicious information about the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, showing that Among is a torturer, murderer and kidnapper, and a corrupt official. According to the prosecution, the information is likely to ridicule, degrade or demean and promote hostility against Among. Burora has since denied the charges against him. During the launch of the second quarter rule of law report, which details the status of the rule of law in Uganda, Bernard Owundo, the president of the Agenda Law Society, highlighted the issues that they would like the government to pay attention to. Among areas of concern by the Law Society was upholding the human rights by the government during its enforcement of the law, citing instances of demolition of residences in Luigi during the NEMA operations. The Law Society says they are in full support of ensuring the protection of the environment. However, they stated that the government should not overlook the issue of human rights while enforcing the law.
While we support the government's effort to protect the environment, and we know that they are actually following the National Environment Management Act, we continue to urge government to ensure that they place human rights at the center of environmental protection. Enforcement should be done in a way that respects human rights. That is key, and we have highlighted it in the report. Number two is that there shouldn't be selective application of the law. If we are saying that we are dealing with the law to preserve wetlands, we should ensure that the law is not being selectively applied. So everyone who is in the wetland should be dealt with.
They further highlighted a breach of the law by the government regarding freedom of assembly and freedom of association.
We highlight and continue to appeal to government to respect the decision in Mwanga Chivumbi versus Attorney General. In Mwanga Chivumbi versus Attorney General, the court was very clear on the respect for assembly as provided for in the Constitution. the court has stated clearly that the freedom of assembly, the right to assemble, is a right which is inherent, and it cannot be taken away on the basis or on the assumption that there will be a breach of peace.
Citing the case of Mwanga Chivumbi versus the Attorney General, they say government must protect this inherent right. Owondo further expressed concern over leaders who support corruption, saying this has cost a lot in terms of offering services to the populace.